Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everything. Terima orang lain.
Terima apa?
Terima sama sekarang lah.
Kero Amin, what's up guys?
Sama pun Kero Amin.
Sebab perempuan tak punya what's up guys. What's up ladies lah. So saya ada 1, 2, 3, 4. Semua houseman. Houseman ni doktor
pelatih
pegawai perubatan siswa Zahan.
Pelatih
tapi diorang ada extra sikit. Pegawai siswa Zahan kontrak. Kan?
Betul.
Sedih kan? Sebut kontrak sedih. Tak perkenalkan diri eh? Tak perkenalkan diri. Seorang nama dulu. Nama apa-apalah yang korang nak beritahu.
Okay, hi, assalamualaikum. Nama saya Shalza.
Hello, can you hear me?
Nama saya Anis. Nama saya Fazira.
Nama saya Aida.
Okay. Itu je?
Itu je lah. Cukup lah.
Nama je. Okay. Soalan pertama eh. Saya nak cerita. Kita nak tanya sorang-sorang. Maksudnya pengalaman diorang, jawapan diorang based on pengalaman diorang lah. Based on diorang punya apa yang diorang lalui. Yang pertama sekali kontrak houseman. Dulu kita orang lepas habis medical punya ni terus masuk. Masuk kerja. So korang berapa lama nak tunggu?
Okay.
Selepas habis medical student.
Okay, after habis medical student, since I'm graduated from Egypt, it took about like 1 year. One year lah, more than 1 year, lebih kurang macam tu untuk masuk ke dalam HBO. Since we have to
Tunggu waktu
the process and everything.
Saya dengan Syaza university sama, so kita orang memang tunggu setahun 3 bulan macam tu lah. Sangat lama, 1 tahun 3 bulan.
Satu batch tu semua setahun 3 bulan.
Ada juga kalau yang daftar lambat lah. Lagi lambat lah dia orang tunggu.
Setahun 3 bulan. Boleh kerja MACD.
Hilang semua ilmu. Lupa dah.
Sebelum tu memang saya tak
kerja
lah.
Tak kerja lah.
Tak kerja.
You,
kalau
pun
berapa, just setahun. Kita
orang pun
sama.
Berapa lama tunggu?
10 months. 10 months.
Kau tak ada buat apa-apa lah.
Tolong family business.
Okay, you pun tak buat apa-apa.
Saya ada kerja. Waktu tu kerja macam nurse dekat apa tu? Dialysis center.
Jenis?
Tak tahu. Bukan, saya tak tahu lah nurse ke apa. Tapi dekat dialysis center lah. So orang yang dialysis
orang yang kelab kan depan tu.
Tak, yang buat mesin pasang cuci darah.
Saya tak tahu pun. Boleh tiru. Lain tu dia enjoy masa.
Time tu nak kumpul duit konon.
So dia tenang. Tak ada ni sebelum masuk houseman.
Stress free.
Stress free. Okay, betul-betul. Tapi kena ada expectation lah, kena yes. Tahu kan apa benda. Yes. So yes. Apa yang perlu dibuat sebelum masuk houseman?
For saya, before I enter here, I pergi like pre-HO course.
Sebenarnya sangat helpful kalau pre-HO course tu sangat-sangat
helpful.
Sebab tahu tengah enjoy dekat rumah, so we know maybe during the course kita study sikit lah, revise few topics.
Because medical student life and housemanship life is
so different.
And sometimes what you learn dekat medical school pun lain dengan what is practice here. Especially when you're studying overseas kan. Sometimes the practice in Malaysia is different.
And then medical pun is a continuous learning process. So you cannot stop. Kalau you stop, obviously you will forget what you have learned. So memang kena like continuously.
Mana yang tunggu lama-lama kat dalam rumah tu, baca-baca sikit.
Betul.
Just a little bit everyday helps. Sikit-sikit pun tak apa.
Betul? Supaya tak lupa langsung.
Supaya tak lupa langsung. Because you tak lupa, you just need to refresh.
Kalau sendiri houseman, mungkin tak sempat nak study betul-betul. Macam kena hujan.
Memang tak sempat.
So nanti kita cerita lagi. Soalan next round. Soalan satu lagi. Nak tanya. Bila dah masuk kerja kan? So apa macam mana bila dah start masuk kerja tu, apa perasaan bila mula masuk houseman?
Kita semua takut.
Memang takut. Housemanship was the hardest thing I have ever done. Honestly, saya tak ada banyak struggle pun in life.
Boleh buat
quote. Housemanship was the hardest thing I have ever done. internship is the hardest thing to adapt to. Yes. Bagi saya lah. It was the hours are long, the work is susah.
And you kena handle dengan everyone, your superior, your colleague,
the middle person that needs to know everything and how to handle everything. So mula-mula adjustment period tu will be very long lah. So that's what you should expect.
So we already expected the worst for House Moon, but then when we actually enter the House Moon ship tu,
what is worse than the worst?
What is worse than the worst?
But no one can ever describe the exact meaning of the worst thing that you have to expect.
Bunyi macam teruk kan?
Bunyi macam teruk.
Permulaan je.
Tapi permulaan je. All smiling faces je.
Kalau tak, kita tak boleh senyum sekarang.
Okay. Tadi cerita pasal yang tak best tak best kan, ya. The worst case yang bila masuk, start masuk kan. Katanya ada tagging. Tagging tu apa? Boleh tak cerita? Siapa-siapa seorang cerita.
Okay. Actually nak guna balik perkataan worst tu. Actually tagging is the worst period. tagging is the worst period. Tagging is the basically the worst period of your housemanship lah, in every department. Sebab you will enter different department every 4 months. So you baru je adapt, then rasa happy dengan department yang sebelum tu. You rasa okay, depan dia buat kerja, dah happy, dah ni, dah dah kenal dengan bos. Tiba-tiba masuk department baru, start zero balik. Basically when you already on the top, when you start tagging, you are down below again. But then it's really a good process and it's really 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 important for our opinion lah. It's important to have tagging period sebenarnya. Sebab I myself I wouldn't berani to start my night shift if I don't go through tagging period first.
No matter how bad your tagging period is, it is so essential. You cannot survive in that department without your tagging period. Tagging is an initial period when you enter a department. Usually it's about a period from 1 to 2 weeks that allows you to adjust to the department lah. The hours are very long. It is 7 to 10 p.m. usually lah, standardized, with about 1 or 2 days off in between. So this tagging period
sampai
10 malam. Every day.
Berapa hari?
14 days. But memang tamprin pukul 7 sepatutnya. But we
never came at 7.
We come to work around 6.
Datang awal, balik lambat.
Balik tak pukul 10 eh. Balik pukul 11, 12.
But it's essential. It's important. So if you ever hear about people abolishing tagging period ke,
we don't agree.
We don't really recommend it. It's important.
Sebab you masuk department baru, you kena kenal sistem department tu. So tagging is the time for you to get used to the system in the department. Sebab each department has their own rules. So
and people make compromises for you when you are in your tagging period. People understand you are still tagging, you don't know yet the system, you're not familiar. So there is still some excuse for you, only way for you to make mistakes lah. So that's good.
Ada kenangan yang pahit tak waktu tagging?
Adik
kita tanya sorang-sorang.
Okay. Kita tanya
Syahla.
Dr. Aida dulu.
Okay, if you ask me personally, my honest opinion is always when we started our first posting lah, tagging dekat medical posting. My first posting was medical, so I was with Anis. Memang brings back memories. Sebab that was the only time, and I think we were the only batch yang we tag for one whole month. We tag for one whole month every day. And it's not
2 sampai 10.
No, it's not even 7. Okay.
It's 6 a.m. 6 a.m.
6 a.m. until 12 a.m. And actually not 6 a.m. We came at 4. 5 and 4:30, 5 a.m. Sebab ialah masa tu first posting. I graduated from Egypt, so banyak nak kena belajar sistem Malaysia. And then
Sistem komputer.
Lepas tu medical. Then so we tag for 1 month. And masa tu memang we literally lost like 10 kilos. 10 kilos. We lost 10 kilos. So it was a good thing lah.
Sekarang
dah gain balik.
Tak boleh tanya soalan. Fazira punya bad experience. Tengok.
Bad experience eh. Basically
kenangan paling tak best.
Kenangan tak best tu sebenarnya more to long working hours lah. Almost the same macam orang during first posting. We stay until like middle, pukul 12, pukul pernah juga sampai pukul 2. And then the next day we come back early around 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock to make sure that we can especially waktu tu kita first posting dekat Pediatric. Waktu tu dekat Hoshas dah lama dah tak ada first poster. Because they said when you came to Pediatric as a first poster, extend until proven otherwise. So we have to catch up macam seniors kita orang kerja juga. So itu memang senang nangis lah. Tapi every time datang kerja ada good colleague semua. Okay lah, slowly adapting.
Doktor
Anis.
Doktor Anis punya pengalaman.
It was during my first posting as well. It was during my tagging period juga. I accidentally charted an investigation, a blood investigation, and it was an abnormal result which should have been taken like urgent intervention. But I did not because I did not know. So I went for another patient to review, and then when the rounds were started, then the patient was fine. The patient was fine, but the blood investigation was not taken into intervention lah. So I got scolded very badly, very badly. But it was my fault, of course. That was my one of my bad experiences lah. But it taught me that you need to be alert even when you chat pun you tak perasan what you chatting is wrong. But that was being our first posting lah.
Tagging first posting tu macam time tu ambil ABD pun sambil nangis. Makan pun tak sempat. Lah habis round pun nangis. But then kita continue je kerja.
Sakit
tu.
Susah
lah. Because it's very stress. Okay, actually I dengan Fazira is the first posting pediatric. So Fazira is actually at the SCN neonatal dekat pediatric ward, general pediatric. So in pediatric ward, what happened is you handle budak-budak more than 1 year old. So when in 1 year old, sama je dengan SCN, you have to learn macam mana how to give fluid according to the weight. Everything in pits according to the weight. So
it pits needs calculator.
Needs calculator. So from the beginning of the day, you macam you have to adapt that. Macam oh okay, tahu pits is another living creature. But then in order you are first poster and you have to adapt that. And plus oh macam apa macam mana nak order FBC?
Order blood pun tak pandai.
So, apa tu lagi ambil black?
Imagine paling sikit.
Baby kecil-kecil ni tu kan.
Ni tak nampak.
And then for me, I feel like I'm like not very functional because okay, I'm first poster. I don't know how to nak request imaging. And then bosses was like, it's okay, you first poster. I saw sini doon. I tak suka macam tu. I was like I should be more functional, but then I cannot because April's poster is very like limited. You macam ada benda lagi you tak tahu macam nak buat.
Yeah. So hey, yes. Tapi I rasa sedih waktu my first posting because
kita tak tahu nak buat. Bos akan tak apalah.
Junior tak boleh bagi senior.
So
rasa tu susah. Kita nak ambil MO yang garang. Walaupun dia junior, walaupun dia baru, kita suruh juga buat. Buatlah. Belajar. Tapi yang baik tu, ni tak apa, tak apa, biar sini yang buat.
yang tu pula terasa kan.
Dan sebenarnya yang paling ni waktu tengok lah Tigers New Case.
New Case tu kena buat apa? Kena club passion.
Kena
passion. Ambil history passion. Tanya yang tanya banyak kali tu. Itu dah tanya lah. So nak tahu apa yang apa cerita kan. So dalam mungkin 50% more than 50% kita punya cerita ni banyak cerita yang worse, yang buruk-buruk, yang tak best kan. So macam mana? Macam mana handle? Macam mana nak go through housemanship, pengalaman sebagai jadi doktor baru, doktor muda, doktor ni, macam mana nak adapt, macam mana nak handle benda-benda ni? Apa yang korang buat?